A large part of our research here at the Precision Medical Instrument Design Lab deals with investigating how medical instruments interact with the tissues and bone inside the body. By developing a deeper understanding of these interactions, we are able to design and develop more effective medical instruments.
So my project deals with medical needles and trying to make them safer and more usable for healthcare providers and for patients. So we're looking at dynamically moving the needle to improve upon medical procedures. So this is applying vibration to the needle, looking at insertion speed, so moving the needle into the tissue at a faster rate, just to see how that affects the insertion mechanics and why the reduction of forces are there.
A portion of our research also deals with robotics, looking at how robotics can be used to enhance physical therapy, and also looking at how haptic robotics can be used to help improve resident training for invasive procedures that they have to perform.
So my project is to develop an empirical model of the insertion force of a medical needle going through soft tissue. And the reason for developing this model is to be able to simulate the forces that a physician would experience as they insert a needle in a variety of medical procedures. So the model that I've been developing, it can be easily transformed to be simulating one procedure to the next, and also simulate the variability that would exist from one patient to the next.
In this lab, we run experiments into real tissue. So we use both cow liver and pig skin to give us results that are analogous to what you would see going into humans. It's cheaper, easier, safer, more ethical to use, say, animal tissue as opposed to human tissue. Occasionally, we'll also run into a plastic gel, which simulates the tissue mechanics pretty well, but it's still not exactly what you see if you go into tissue.
Doing all our own experiments, I get to go down to the learning factory and build all the parts for the experiment, which is real nice, hands-on experience, learning how to machine, use the mills, lathes, things like that.
So currently with a lot of needle insertion procedures, there's a lot of complications, and there's a lot of statistics that show that these complications occur at a higher rate when you're dealing with a less experienced physician. So the goal of developing my model is that we can apply it to medical training and be able to improve the way that these new physicians are trained so that these complications can occur at a much smaller or much lower rate.
The work we do directly impacts society because we're trying to make these needles perform better in medical procedures, and this will reduce pain in patients, reduce healthcare costs, and just have better outcomes from these procedures, and improving quality of life of the patients.